People like to share. After all, we are social animals. But somehow the age of social media has got us sharing more and more, no matter how uninteresting it might be. Even though we know every post gives marketers more and more information about us. So, why do we do it? And could we stop ourselves even if we try? Psychologist Diana Tamir knows she's sometimes guilty of oversharing.
You gonna try this one?
I'm gonna try this one.
Especially when she tries out her favorite new hobby.
It's super satisfying to be able to do a route that you weren't able to do before. That's part of the joy of rock climbing. Getting to the top of a wall can feel rewarding.
You don't have to come to K2 to feel that basic human impulse, the impulse to talk about yourself.
Check it out. People talk about themselves all the time. They talk about themselves when they're having a conversation with other people.
Isn't that sweet? They talk
about themselves when they're sharing information about themselves on social media or taking pictures of the thing that they ate for breakfast and posting it for the world to see.
That's a really good one. Yeah.
There's a study that looked at what people tweet about on Twitter, and they found that about 80% of what people are tweeting about is just their own personal experiences.
Why do we enjoy this so much? As a neuroscientist, Diana thinks the answer may be hiding in our brains. So she designed an experiment using an MRI scanner to see how talking about ourselves versus others changes brain activity. Picture it like a public access talk show, with Diana taking the role of the interviewer.
Is it rewarding to talk about yourself? Let's find out.
And a ficus standing in for the scanner.
Hey, Adam.
Hey.
Do you get excited to dress up for Halloween?
Diana asks her subjects to respond to questions about themselves or other people while showing them corresponding photographs.
Does your dad like being photographed? Do you enjoy spending time in nature? Do you like being photographed? Do you enjoy having a dog as a pet?
For Diana, the answers weren't important. What mattered was how her subjects' brains responded to the questions. All of them activated the prefrontal cortex, a region associated with higher thought. But something else happened when a subject answered questions about themselves. Diana saw activation in two brain regions, the ventral tegmental area and the nucleus accumbens. They belong to what neuroscientists call the reward pathway.
So we have these reward pathways in our brain that motivates our behavior by helping us to learn what things in the world feel rewarding that we need or want or desire, like food or sex.
The brain's reward system is powered by a key chemical called dopamine. A surge of dopamine can trigger pleasant feelings, which motivate us to seek further rewards. It's the same system that fires up when people do drugs like cocaine or eat chocolate. So, like drugs, sharing can become addictive. But why does the dopamine system activate when we talk about ourselves?
Humans have a fundamental need to belong or connect with other people. So social connection and making friends and interacting with people are something that we're highly motivated to get. So being part of a group gets you more resources, food, reproductive options than if you were by yourself.
Self-promotion helps establish us as members of a group. And for hundreds of thousands of years, being part of a group has been essential to our survival. Even when we can't see the other people in our group, we still have the instinctual urge to promote ourselves.